Jueves 17 de diciembre, Zuccotti Park, Manhattan. Policías antimotines entran una vez más a Liberty Plaza, la capital de los ocupantes, la cuna del movimiento, aquí en Estados Unidos. Dos días antes, policía militarizada en full poder destruyó la acampada, arrestando algo más de 140 personas, 10 de ellos periodistas. Pero esta vez vinieron a llevarse los libros de la nueva Biblioteca Popular, producto de un flujo de donaciones tras la brutal batida del martes 15.
There was almost a riot. People were really, really not happy about the cops coming in and demanding that the books go with them. So people gathered around and everybody sort of consensed on letting them take the books and just photographing them.
What do you think when in your country being named the land of the free and the home of the brave, they come and take books?
Well,
that should send a sign, right?
To begin with, I don't buy propaganda like that. I look at it at face value and I say that's just not true. Right now we're living in a place that supports this kind of thing. I've read articles where they've called the police professional for doing this. There are people who completely think that that kind of thing is justified, that think that evicting people from their homes, whether it's a tent in a park or a mansion, is the right thing to do, is okay, ever. There are people that think that cops with batons are justified.
About the library, what's the deal with this? Was this what saved or what?
These are all brand new donations.
Estamos aquí en Manhattan, en un estudio jurídico en Madison Street, donde se ha reunido una rueda de prensa para informar a la gente sobre lo ocurrido con la biblioteca. Algo que nosotros presenciamos cuando policías vinieron y se llevaron por segunda ocasión. Se les va a pedir que reemplacen cada libro que ha sido destruido, cada libro que ha desaparecido, y al mismo tiempo donde hay un reconocimiento público de lo que fue hecho. Ha sido algo errado, ha sido algo equivocado. De alguna forma quieren una disculpa del alcalde Bloomberg.
Estoy aquí hablando con la gente de la Biblioteca del Pueblo, del campamento, que fue completamente destruida por la policía hace una semana. Aquí estamos con todos los libros que pudimos recoger de la policía, que son casi mil libros. Destrozados, completamente arruinados. Hay más de 3.000 libros que ni siquiera tenemos, ni siquiera están en nuestras manos. No se sabe dónde están. De los casi 4.000 libros que teníamos en la biblioteca cuando estuvimos en el parque, lo que pasó, lo que hizo el alcalde de esta ciudad es una vergüenza.
I think that the issue of our books being destroyed can't be separated from other issues of police brutality that are coming out every single day, that are occurring every single day. In the United States, for example, protesters at UC Davis, protesters at UC Berkeley, but they also can't be disconnected from U.S. militarism at home and also abroad. I think that all of these questions are related, and I think it's important for us to make connections between what's happening to, you know, just the police overreaction to coming in and clearing the park and police overreactions elsewhere. I wouldn't ever want to equate the destruction of books with destruction of bodies, but I think that that kind of militarization of our police and also other kinds of militarism perpetuated by the U.S., they have to be connected.